Hello everyone, Kilikardovan here playing Football Manager 2018. We are in the beta. Still about 10 days until the game comes out. Or maybe 11, something like that. Maybe 10 when this video is out. Either way, let's look at the schedule, what we have been playing. In the previous episode, we played against Telford and FC United. 1 point is all we got from that, but then we got some easier opponents. Boston United 3-2. This is not as good. Here we go. We can see it was a late finish, 85th minute to end the match. We were lucky to win that. Then against Chorley 2-0, quite easy. Two cup matches against Darlington. Darlington is one of the top teams in the league here, third place at the moment. But we managed to win that and move on to the next round. We lost against Kidderminster, also one of the top teams. They are in second place at the moment in our league. Then we played against Hednesford. They are outside of the league system, in the game, I should say. Quite an easy match, even if it was 1-1 for quite a long time. 65th minute is when we took control, and after that it was easy for us. Newton, 1-0, winning at home, always nice. Actually, I want to have a little look at our home attendance. Seems like some games we get 550 plus. But most it is around 470 to 500. Maybe that depends mostly. Oh yeah, it depends on how many away we get. So we have about 450 of our own supporters, and then depending on how many opponent fans would show up. After Newton, we played against St. Albans. They are also in. I think they are in Vanarama National League South. Yes, a top team in the South Division. We are in the North Division. We didn't stand a chance. Even if it's 2-1, they were so much better than us. Crushing defeat, crushing defeat. After that, Stockport away 1-1. I think they are around our position. Can't find them now. Oh yeah, they're just above us in the league at the moment. Yeah, so they are around our skill level at the moment, but we were quite lucky to get 1-1 because Stockport was a little bit better, probably mostly because of them playing at home. Then Brackley, I think Brackley was last in the league when we played against them. We won 4-1, an easy match, even some nice goals scored. Was a good match. Then Darlington, we did well in the cup against them, but here in the league we didn't stand a chance. Lost 2-0 even when playing at home. But then we played against Bradford, and they're also actually they're not placed that bad in the league, but we played very well against them, especially Greg Rutherford, two goals. I think he had the assist to Maguire's goal as well. Let's have a look a little bit at our team. Sean McDonald, the goalkeeper, Robbie Dale and Nathan Buddle are the people who play the most matches. Ryan Hutchinson, also very important. And our midfield, especially the central midfield, a bit unsure about it. Actually, before we continue here, look at transfer history. We can see Brede Garton and Josh Dolling. We talked about them coming in the previous episode. Brede Garton have not been playing well. We have given him a few chances. He have even dropped down in current ability. So that's not good. Josh Dolling have not played that much. But it is a player I believe in still. He is the third option out of two, because we have been playing with the 4-4-2 or 4-2-4 tactics. We also loaned in Isaac Ward. He was 17 when we loaned in him, but now he is 18 from Rochdale. A very good backup defenseman. I'm very happy to have him on the team. And also, we needed a right defender. And we brought in Ashley Baker from Sheffield Wednesday. Decently solid defenseman. He have only played in the FA Cup qualifying games so far. We'll see if he will play anymore. I guess there is more cup games coming up soon. Yes, FA Trophy instead. So I'm sure he will be playing in those matches. So two more players are in. We are also looking at bringing in players on trials. We will see how that goes. So goal scorers, Greg Rutherford. He's been very strong, especially lately. He's been much better than Dan McGuire in the last five, six matches, something like that. Scoring quite a lot of goals, creating chances. Dan McGuire, he's been okay, nothing special. You can see his average rating is a bit lower than we would have liked. But since Rutherford is also performing, I guess it is okay. The duo is working on top. Robbie Dale, he is the captain at the moment. I think I set him as vice captain, assistant captain. But since the main captain is not playing anymore, he is the main captain now, I guess, in that sense. 43 years old, he is getting older. He has lost half a star in ability, but he's been playing well. Adam Wrightson, we have been using him more lately. At the moment, he's injured. I think that he will have a place in the team now when he gets back from his injury again, because he's been performing quite well. You see, 3 goals, 3 assists. With only 12 points plus 4 matches, he is an up-and-coming player. Hopefully that injury will not hurt his performance. Then we have the midfielders. Dale Hobson have pretty much secured the defensive position on the midfield, this one. And Horner, he's not performing very well. Maybe we need to change his role or something. We can see he's lost half a star. But he should still be our best midfielder. But he needs to lift his performance. We need to see what we can do. But as long as we are playing well, I guess it is okay. He is not living up to his star potential. Nathan Buddle, he started the season very poorly. Probably because I had him... let's look here. I guess he didn't really like, I think he was playing as stopper or cover. I guess he didn't like that, he moved into, played more focus on defense. And after that, he's been playing a lot better. So, yeah, very important player. Ryan Hutchinson, the other defenseman, also is playing very solid football. We have Cartwright. Right side of the defense. He's been very solid. We can't complain anything. Not any star player, but yeah, we will see. Maybe we should let Baker play a little bit more just to get his feet wet, and maybe he can outperform Cartwright. But yeah, we can't complain anything about Cartwright so far this season. So we need to keep him playing. Jarrett Rivers, on the other hand, we are not really happy with his performance. He's a good player. He's a very strong player. Maybe we need to work on his crossing a little bit. Let's see if we can improve that way. Yeah, I'm not really happy with him. And that is why Wrightson been playing instead of him. We will see. And with Robbie Dale getting older, these three players, we are a bit unsure. That is the position I would like like to get a player in the most, because at the moment you only have these three on, and they need to fill two positions. We do not really have any other option than them three, so we need one more player there. And that the some of the people coming in on trials should fill that position. Gestolling, see the new striker, one goal, one assist. I think both of them are from cup games. Yes, he only played a few minutes in the league so far. And also, Sean Reed have been playing a little bit. No glorious performances. And Dave McTiernan, 43 years old, he started out as the captain. He started out as the defensive central midfielder. But Hobson, Dale Hobson is much better in that position, even if their star ability is not as high. So he's just been playing very, very good. So we... Yeah, Dave McDaniel have been stepping aside, and we are trying to get Brad Garton to play there a little bit as well. Not going that greatly. Actually, I want to have a look at this as well. We are still pretty... Ah! We moved up to 15th place in the media prediction now. That is nice to see that we are improving in that regard. So 9th place after 17 matches. I feel like that is a very good result. We have only lost 5 matches. Now, next match, it's against Leamington. One of the teams we had as options in the poll, they got 4 votes out of 24. I think it was 24. So 4 out of 24, they came in, they were tied for 3rd place with that. And they are in 18th place at the moment, and they are predicted to be in 19th place. So it is a team that we should win, especially when we play at home. Let's see if we can have a good team talk here ahead of the match. The briefing. We are expected to win this one, and we will be going with a counter mentality accordingly. I'm not really sure if that is how it works. Let's just go with that one. They were neutral to that. Formation. Oh, happy! That is the first time I got them happy with the formation. Very nice to see that. And I also saw this. You can add scenario. So we can tell the team that I want you to win with 2 goals today. You can also set a minute where you want that win that lead to be. But I'm not going to set that anything there. And you can also change the mentality and such here as well for that scenario. Not really sure what it means or how it is used. Let's add it for now. Does it affect this screen? Or is... Can I click on it? No, that's just an edit. Is there a way for inside of the match to activate this scenario? Or... Oh, is it... Maybe it is when... When we lead with 2 goals, no matter what time it is... Ah, okay. So if we lead with two goals, with 20 minutes left, then we will change tactics and go for maybe contain and highly structured. If you have a 2 goals lead with 20 minutes left, that must be it. That could be super useful. Let's try it. Let's see if we can make it come into fruition. Other than that, not really anything to say. Once, when I did this, Baker was new in the team. He had not yet played, and think it was ahead of the cup games against Darlington. When I went in here and had a talk, I could talk about him playing his first match for the team. So you can say, this is his first match, let's all work together to help him, or something like that. So some useful things, I hope. I hope I am using them correctly. We will see about that. Now we're just waiting for the match to start. See, we are big favorites for this match, or at least decently big favorites. Everyone is healthy. Do we have anyone on the side that we need to put in? Maybe Bradley Garton instead of Dave McTiernan. You see that we have Jordan Lidler on the bench because we do not have anyone that can fill the wing position, as I have mentioned. Intensity. This is also new. I guess it was in the previous games, but you couldn't see it. I made an example here where I changed some of the settings to make intensity go up. And if we hold our mouse button over it, we can see the level of effort required from the players in this tactic, which it in turn affects their condition and likelihood of injury, is impacted by the chosen levels of closing down, tempo, the style of tackling, the overall team mentality. The more demands made of the players, the more intensity is required from them to carry out the tactic to a high standard. So there are risks with having a high intensity. But I made a tactics for maybe if we are chasing a goal late in a match, maybe we can switch to this. I put it at attacking fluid, and let's look at the some of the changes I made. Guess nothing really super special about it. Only the tackling that affects intensity that I haven't changed, I think. But not really in depth in that new thing in the game yet. Now let's push into the game. Let's see. Okay, one more push. There we go. Jarrett Rivers is a little bit out of match conditioning because he's been injured. He's just back. And he's not at full peak performance yet. Feel like we should let the assistant manager take care of it. And two positives, I guess, is good enough. Hopefully, it will translate into a good performance on the pitch. We start by losing the ball, I was about to say, but we got it back. Not really a big deal. Usually nothing happens with the first possession of the game. You can see that 14-15 minutes have been played. Nothing has happened so far in the match. We just had a shot on target, but it was not worthy of a highlight. This is a very uneventful match, which is bad for us. I feel like we are actually... I actually set for the more intense formation to be used. That was a bit of a mistake. So going into halftime... that was a bit of a mistake. I didn't mean to play with it. I was just showing you... I guess that happens sometimes. Do we have any tired players that we need to change? Nothing really special. Robbie Dale and Jarrett are the two most tired, and we do not have anyone that can play instead of them. So team talk is of course important. We're gonna let the assistant manager take care of that. Didn't really have the effect we would have liked. So here we are testing the oddness of Football Manager. We played attacking, we didn't create anything. If we go down to counter, will we be able to get chances now? Leamington had the first chance of the half, but we managed to steal the ball, at least for a little bit. Okay, I hope now that we will get the highlight. There we go, a corner. The corner moves in, and we didn't really Maybe now. Maybe. Is Maguire offside? Or is that a goal for Rivers? No, we get the goal. Whew. See, now that ball comes and we can see Maguire is far from offside and finds Rivers. Jarrett Rivers, he needed that goal. Very important for us. And would like to see the league table now. When we get the highlight, we're going to have a look at it. See if we are moving up again. Nothing happening after that goal. Okay, 15 minutes left, and it looks like Lamington is getting this highlight. And we can see we are at the moment at in 8th place, same points as 7th place and playoff. But then Lamington scores. It is Bishop. Obeng created that chance from the right side of the pitch. Edwards with a good pass. Obeng a lot of time, and Bishop. That was not good. So we have about 14 minutes left to play, and we need that goal. Time is running out. And it looks like Lamington. Oh, we're gonna get a red card. Red card on Lidl. Our left defenseman. I guess we need to push for a draw here. 1-1. Greg Rutherford, you can come out. And we do not have. Yes, put in Isaac Ward. I used to have a left defenseman, that guy. Downing, I think. Here on the bench, but now I think it was probably ahead of the previous match. I put in Isaac Ward instead. We're gonna continue to play without a left defenseman and see if we can keep 1-1. So, 5 minutes left. Lamington is getting a highlight. Oh, you see the space. Edwards, this is going to be a goal. Oh, it's just outside. Another highlight directly after it, and maybe it will be our highlight now. Yes, Dale got space, and we will not find anyone, but it is a corner. It is a corner. Last time we scored on a corner. Actually, we have had 5 corners this match. And we have no one in front of goal. What the hell, team? I have not set any instructions for corners, but clearly we probably need to do that now, because that was a total mess. We only get 1 point against Lamington. In the previous games, you could see what the assistant manager wanted to say. I guess that is not possible any longer. But I'm still gonna trust him. Unlucky boys, it just wasn't our day. That is true. And that red card on Lidl didn't help us at all. And we can see Dan McGuire only had 6.4. Same as Rivers and Robbie Dale. And Rivers with a goal and still only. Oh, yeah, actually. Oh, that was. Never mind, that was the first half and not the second half. So, actually only Robbie Dell with 6.6 and our central defenders with 6.4 underperformed. So, 6 players are at the club for trials at the moment. We can see that potential ability on all of them are quite good. Tom Craddock is decently good right now, but we still haven't revealed all the stats for the players here. They have been here for 2 days or 3 days now. So we are getting there. I think we need to sign one of them. I think Tom Craddock is the only real attacker. All others are best as wingers. We will see what we will find among them. Ben Roberts, interesting acceleration, natural fitness, finishing could be interesting, but that crossing, not too happy about that. Matthew Rimmer, left side is his speciality. Looks like he could be a decent option as well, but passing, big problem. But there will be problems with all players we try to get in here. Otherwise, they wouldn't be here on a free transfer. I guess, actually, Declan Watson looks quite interesting as well, but it is still uncertain if he will be a good option. Would like to have one of these players make it into the team, but we will see who we pick. It depends on what kind of stats they will end up with. We are now in 17th of November. Next episode, we're gonna play two matches against Spennymoor. That is around the new year. One on the 26th of December and one on the January 1st. In the next episode, we're gonna play two times against Spennymoor. First on the 26th of December and then on January 1st against Spennymoor two times. That will be interesting. Before that, we have some tough matches, I guess, coming up as well. Salford is in the lead of the league. Could be tough. We will see what happens. I will do my best, and then we will get into the matches against Spennymoor next time. And we will also see if we have signed any of the players on trial. Maybe I will try to look for something else to sign as well. But if so, it will most likely be in January after our matches against Spennymoor. We'll see. Until then, I am Killer Cow Divine. Thank you all for watching.